So let's get more deeper into the terminology. So we need to know this terminology so we can easily understand our future lectures. So what is metadata? So non-Yocto world, metadata is a set of data that describes and gives information about other data. Coming to Yocto world, metadata, it refers to the build instructions. It refers to the commands and data which are used to indicate what versions of software are used, where they are obtained from, what all patches which I need to apply. So metadata is nothing but the build instructions. For example, take what should be the metadata for the kernel. What should be the metadata for kernel? It should be how to build this kernel. I have to use make command. I have to use make menu config. I have to use make install, make modules install. So these are the commands. And where I can get this kernel image or kernel source code, I have to mention the website or the Git repository where this particular kernel image is present. And then if I have any patches related to my hardware, I have to mention this. Which version of kernel I have to use, I have to mention this. So this is all known as metadata. So I have given an example of kernel image, and this applies to all the packages. Like it can apply to the Git package, it can apply to USB utils package. There are many packages. So all for each and every particular package or for each and every thing which is used in the Linux image, you need to specify the metadata. So metadata in Yocto, it is a collection of configuration files. It has an extension .conf, recipes .bb and .bb append, which this has the extension of .bb and .bb append, classes, which has an extension of .bb class, includes, which has an extension of inc. So we'll be looking in, we have to understand all these files to better understand your code. You have to understand what kind of configuration files we have and how is a recipe written, what are the different classes and what are the includes. So if you understand all of this, then you will be easily understanding how to write your own custom Linux distribution. You can easily write your own custom Linux distribution, and you can easily debug while you're having any issues when you're building the image.